It's my pleasure to welcome all of you this morning for our 18th Telecom Leadership Forum, which we have themed as Digital Disruption and Consolidation. When we started this platform 17, 18 years back, the idea was to get all the stakeholders of the telecom sector, be they the operators and various kinds of operators. At that time, there used to be so many types of operators, the equipment and solution companies, the policy makers, the value-added services and the apps companies, the handset players, all of them, to get them together on a single platform and take up important raging issues of the day and do brainstorming, do idea and experience sharing, and create food for thought, create ideas, create points which can be then taken up further as the leaders present in the room go back to their respective work. So idea was to have a platform where all the stakeholders come together and talk and discuss. As the theme suggests, digital disruption and consolidation, obviously throughout the day we will have speakers talking about it, but there are two facts which, so obviously it's digital which is to a great extent responsible for the consolidation and disruption that we are seeing in the sector today. For good or for bad, we really don't know. I think time will tell. But by and large, the opinion is that digital disruption has been very, very good. But what all of us need to keep in mind are two things, and they are the hard realities, they are the ground realities of the day. One is the health of the industry. I don't think I need to say anything besides just mentioning that the health of the telecom industry is very, very critical, and it has to be in the as they say, in the pink of health for everything else to then happen after that. And the other ground reality, a hard fact, is the quality of services. So the quality of services is, I think, I shouldn't say poor, but it is way, way, way below what expectations are. And with 5G, I think those expectations only go up. I was talking to some people a couple of weeks back, and we were talking about 5G, and they said that they had nothing to do with the telecom sector, but they said, why are you doing something on 5G, and why are you talking about digital and all, because what I actually get, I have a 3G phone connection, but what I get on my phone is not even 1G. So I think the objective of all of us and objective of this disruption and consolidation is actually to ensure that the health of the industry is good, and finally we have happy customers, happy consumers at the end of the day. We have a very, very tight schedule. We have a lot of eminent people coming and speaking and sharing their ideas and thoughts with us. My only request, and as I take up one session at a time, my only request to all the speakers is to please make sure that they do not go beyond the time that is sort of been promised by them, and we are able to keep to the timelines as far as the flow of the program is concerned. Before I invite our first speaker, I would like to really thank our partners. Without their support, this would not have been possible. So this entire conference is being powered by Sterlite, our platinum partner Qualcomm, and digital infrastructure partner is the HP Enterprise, and the IoT partner is Aeris Communications. So really a big thank you to all of them. Obviously, we have got excellent support from the various industry associations, including COAI, TAIPA, Broadband India Forum, Telecom Equipment Manufacturer Association, and ACTO. Just one housekeeping announcement, that there is a feedback form which has been given to all of you. Please please, please fill up that feedback form and give it to us, as it will give us a lot of ideas and a lot of inputs on how and where we need to improve going forward. And obviously there is a, at the reception desk outside, there is a special subscription offer for Voice and Data. And if anybody is interested, they can just walk over to that desk and register to be a subscriber. So without taking too much time, I would once again like to welcome you on behalf of Voice and Data and on behalf of CyberMedia, and I hope that this is a very, very productive day that we all have today. To start, and I think a lot of people say that what's so special about it, but I think light is very, very important. Light is really, I think all of us are searching for light in some way or the other. So what better way, and as it has been a customary thing in India, what better way to start a program like this with lamp lighting. So can I request our distinguished speakers of the first session to please come over and do the lamp lighting for us, Mr. Rajan Matthews, Dr. Kathuria, Harmeen, Balaji, and Mr. Rao. Also, I would like to invite Arjun and Vinay and Ravi to join the lamp lighting. We seem to have run out of wicks, but I think you can. You can add more fire to the fire. Thank you so much. Before I invite our first speaker, Dr. Rajat Kathuria, there's a small a film that we would like to show to you, and this also revolves around the theme of consolidation and digital, and I think it sums up very, very nicely what is it that we are going through currently and what is it and where is it that we want to go. Can we have the movie, please?
Since the time this business started, the number of players proliferated into 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 players. And the chat generally in the back room was, when will we consolidate and become a lesser number of manageable players? One of the advantages of consolidation is that a number of peripheral players and marginal players who suffer on account of very, very large companies are eliminated from the scene. Large companies have resources, both in terms of manpower, technology, finances, and they tend to be able to take the big decisions that a country like ours needs.
Well, one of the benefits is that we now have less competition for spectrum. The quantum of spectrum has also increased, and I think that's good. The consolidation has brought about that change in terms of the spectrum. The use of the spectrum, the efficiency of the spectrum has been enhanced as a result of consolidation. Obviously, we can focus the investments in our network. The emergence of 4G technology, clearly as a result of the benefits of consolidation.
Consolidation of an industry primarily impacts in three ways. One, it helps it create synergies. Creating synergy is removing the redundancy, and that helps to make a healthy business. The second is resource optimization. That's another one which probably helps to grow and do a self-sustained growth into that industry. The third, of course, is a consumer benefit.
is better for the industry. Because it's always good to have a few strong players rather than too many fractured players. So the main advantages, I would say, maybe one good focus on the quality of service, because all the players focus much on the customer experience. Number two, I would say better return on the investment, because the utilization of the investment will go up. So it will get better. Faster adoption to the new technology.
Consolidation that has happened in the last 2 years, in long run, it is very, very beneficial for the overall industry, because now we have only serious players who are actually serious and who have deep pockets to sustain in this market. So they are only left in the market.
This consolidation happening, is it good? I say absolutely good for the industry. Telecom is an industry which is heavily capital intensive. And there is no way where 13 people split on and keep on spending money the way it needs to happen. So in my opinion, this was absolutely a
different thought. Telecommunications is actually a different type of industry where the technology changes periodically. So the people who have the most advanced technology actually end up dominating the market, and this cycle of the evolution makes it a natural process for the consolidation. So I believe that this consolidation is, on one hand, very healthy because it will leave larger companies.
Standpoint, I think a lot of benefits from the consolidation that's happening in the industry. Companies of scale would deliver very competitive data packages and voice packages.
Industry.